thank you again, Bob. And again, thanks, my thanks to all of you for being here. Today for us in the police department is the most important and significant day of the year. 29th of September each year is the day when we remember and pay tribute to those police officers who have given their lives in the cause of their duty in providing for the safety and security of the people of Queensland. And today particularly, we remember sadly two of our own in the last 12 months. For us, the 12 months is the 12 months from the 29th of September each year. And firstly, that was Sergeant Daniel Stiller, who was killed on the 1st of December last year, conducting a wide load escort in central Queensland. And 6 months to the day later, we lost Detective Senior Constable Damian Leeding on the 1st of June this year. Damian died after having been shot 3 days earlier, being a first responder police officer to an armed robbery in progress at the Pacific Pines Tavern in the Gold Coast hinterland. Both Dan and Damien were two of the finest, most decent people you would ever wish to have to meet. They were also outstanding police officers. They gave their lives, providing for the safety and security of the people of Queensland and protecting others. Today, as we have in the past, we pay tribute to them again. And the 137 other Queensland police officers have also given their lives in the course of their duty over time. The total here is 139. I wish and hope that that total would never grow, that never again would we have to add to the list of names of officers killed on duty. But I also know, and we all know in the police department, the practical reality of that, and the fact that you can't do a job that provides for the safety and security of others in the world and the environment we live in without putting your own safety at risk. And no matter how capable the officers are, there comes a time when the dark forces of fate combine a particular time, place and circumstance. And for us, our worst time is with us in the loss of a colleague. I'd also like to pay tribute today to the police officers throughout Australia as well. Dan and Damien's names this morning in a dawn service were added to the list at the National Police Memorial in Canberra. Dan Stiller was number 749 and Damien Leeding was number 750. So in total, the 750 officers throughout Australia who we also remember today. Thank you, I'm happy to take any questions.
Commissioner, is it particularly hard for Queensland this year? Two deaths in Queensland, none in any other state or even New Zealand.
That's correct. It's the case, of course, that we would wish that we could go through every year in any given year without anyone being lost at all. So we would never want to lose anyone. We didn't want to lose our two officers. We're grateful that in every other jurisdiction and in New Zealand, no police officers have been killed on duty this year. We only wish it hadn't happened here. We had 3 years. Our last officer was Fred Irwin, who was shot and killed in 2007. And we're always grateful that every year that goes by, that we don't lose anyone. But regrettably, that risk is always going to be there.
Damian Leeding's death, obviously really tragic and in such violent circumstances. Do you think that has brought it home for a lot of Queenslanders? Because there seem to be a lot of sort of members of the general public in there today with flowers and a part of the service.
We're always grateful when we lose an officer. We're always grateful for the community support. And that particularly in the local community where the officer's from, is always quite significant. But even we, I guess, were just completely overcome almost really with the huge response from the public and the community that was generated after the death of Detective Senior Constable Damian Leeding. We are extremely grateful for that support. Damien's death seemed to touch and I thought there were quite a few messages in there. I thought it was the community saying we support you. I thought as well, I think that added to it as well, you know, young people, young families, and it certainly was something though that was quite quite extraordinary to see, and it was an outpouring of grief and support that we indeed were extremely grateful for, and meant a lot to the family, and meant a lot to other officers as well.
There were family members here from officers who were killed 10 years ago. Obviously through ongoing support from the police service and obviously due to having police officers as spouses as well, is that something that you can promise the widows of the two officers on today, that in 10 years time you'll still be there and helping out as much as now?
Well, I certainly believe so, and I hope so. Culture and tradition are important parts of any organisation, and for the police department culture and tradition are really important. And in my view, you can't ask people to go and do the work that they do to provide for the protection of the broader community, put their own safety at risk, and in some places give their lives up. And it's just another job. It has to be more than that. There has to be a sense about it that we value people. And that when we say things like, you're part of the police family, and we'll never forget you, and we'll look after your family, there's a truth and a reality to that. And I believe there is. And we're also very grateful, you know, for the support of the community and the role of the media in letting the public and the community know about some of these things. That's so important as well. So a day of mixed emotions for us. It's really important to do this. I thought the service today and the march were fine tributes to all 139 officers. But what is important is that we continue to do this each year and continue to do it on a daily basis in terms of the support for the families.
How aware are the police officers of the risk they face every time they go on patrol? Is it at the forefront of their minds?
That's a really good question. I thank you for asking it. Every time a police officer starts a shift, they don't know what's going to happen. In some ways, that's part of the enjoyment of being a police officer. It's the challenge of not knowing what you're going to confront, and the challenge of being able to meet and deal with whatever that is. But there is that sense of uncertainty, and you can never take away the risk and danger. But what is important though is that they have to back themselves. They have to be confident in their ability to deal with whatever they confront. If they didn't, then that wouldn't be a good thing at all. They'd go out and they'd be uncertain, they'd be unsure, and you can't have that. So despite the dangers, police officers, when they start each shift, have to be confident, not arrogant or overconfident or egotistical, but they have to be quietly confident in their ability to deal with whatever they face and confront. Without that, you wouldn't have the quality of person that you need as a police officer.